Good morning, everyone. It is now 9:20. We will begin on schedule at 9:30. Just wanted to leave folks time to get to your chairs. Thank you. 2020, please stand for your stationary processional. Grandparents, aunts, uncles, and siblings who are here this morning, and those who are watching from home, thank you. Thank you for sharing your amazing daughters with us over the last 4 years. The strength of our community is rooted in the fact that each graduate has loved ones in her life who thinks that her education, her spiritual formation, and her social maturation is important. It does take a village, and we were grateful for this partnership with you. And ladies, today is an especially proud and gratifying moment for your parents. They've worked hard to help each of you reach your full potential. They've endured the trials and tribulations of parenting. Before you head off to college, be sure to find a heartfelt and sincere way to thank your parents for their love, for their guidance, and for their support. And as you all know, our DSHA faculty and staff is exceptional. Who else could have changed their educational delivery approach over a weekend and done it so effectively? This faculty has challenged and supported you. When you have that moment in the next couple of weeks when you head off to college, when you have that moment that makes you realize how prepared you are for this next chapter of your life, be sure to write one of your teachers or other staff members and say thank you. It's no easy feat to help each student achieve at her highest level academically, to help her mature socially and emotionally, to find it in herself to be kind to herself, and to help her really understand God's deep love for her. And our faculty embraces this mission every day. But colleagues, today, as you watch the women of 2020 walk across this stage, take pride in knowing that all of your efforts have made a lasting impression on each of these young women. You helped us deliver on our mission to develop our students into capable young women of faith, heart, and intellect who accept the gospel call that live lives that will make a difference. And now, Father Devin, SDS, will lead us in prayer.
And so we begin, united by the faith that we share in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. How are you, Dashers? Are you excited? Lucy, are you beyond excited? Where's Lucy? Lucy wrote me a nice note at the end of the school year, and as she was describing what was going to happen next year, she said that she recounted it a little bit, and she says, I'm beyond excited. So I hope you all are too. The class of this graduation for the class of 2020 is like no other in the 127 years of DSHA history. As Mrs. Brock remarked recently, no one's going to forget the class of 2020. And so as we begin, let us pray. That we may do the good works that lead people to God, we pray. Loving Father, we are important to you, for you keep entrusting to us the mission of making your name and your agape love known. Strengthen us in our weakness, make us savor the message of the gospel, that in the footsteps of your Son, Jesus, we may bring your light and salty taste to the world and carry out this task with great joy. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. And now I invite Kathleen Cullen, class of 2005, to proclaim the first.
A reading from the prophet Jeremiah. For I know well the plans I have in mind for you, says the Lord. Plans for your welfare and not for your woe, so as to give you a future of hope. When you call me and come and pray to me, I will listen to you. When you look for me, you will find me. Yes, when you seek me with all your heart, I will let you find me, says the Lord, and I will change your lot. I will gather you together from all the nations and all the places to which I have banished you, and bring you back to the place from which I have exiled you. The word of the Lord. Thanks.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said, you are the salt of the earth, but if salt loses its taste, with what can it be seasoned? It's no longer good for anything but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city set on a mountaintop cannot be hidden, nor can they light a lamp and then put it under a bushel basket. It is set on a lampstand where it gives light to all in the house. Just so, your light must shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father. The Gospel of the Lord. You are the salt of the earth. Given the gospel that your classmates chose for today, I'd like to start, if you'd allow me, with a salty story. Laugh, laugh, come on. All right. Back when I was a little boy, my mom and dad and I had a summertime custom of spending a weekend visiting friends of my dad's parents, Minnie and Leonard Klingsell, in Santa Cruz, California. Santa Cruz, at the time, was a sleepy resort city at the northern end of the Monterey Bay. It has a beautiful beach, a super fun boardwalk with games, roller coaster, and other rides. I remember the first time we made this trek, my first visit to the ocean. My folks had told me that the ocean, in contrast to Lake Tahoe, is all salt water. I found that a little hard to believe, figuring that God would have to have one heck of a big salt shaker to salt the water. So after our arrival, we grabbed our towels and walked down to the beach. I was surprised that the water was colder than I thought it would be, colder than a swimming pool, but I went in anyway. What do you think was the first thing I did? I drank the water, yes, and quickly spit it out. I don't drink salt water anymore. But when the waiter brings my meal at a restaurant and says, "Don't touch the plate, it's very hot," what do you think I do? Touch the plate, exactly. What's Jesus getting at by saying you or we are the salt of the earth? You'll remember, I hope, from your theology classes that the Catholic approach to reading a scripture passage is to read it in context. And so today's reading is located within the context of the Sermon on the Mount. So if we go back to the beginning of the 15th chapter, we find the Beatitudes. Blessed are the poor in spirit, those who mourn, the meek, those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, the merciful, the clean of heart, the peacemakers. I'd like to propose that it was not by chance that Jesus put, "Blessed are the poor in spirit," at the top of the list. This poverty is the foundation of living all of the other Beatitudes. Some call this poverty of spirit, others dependence on God. Father Jordan called it trust in divine providence, and it was at the core of his personal spirituality that he bequeathed to all Salvatorians and to you, the class of 2020. Father Jordan knew that we cannot go it alone through life, that we don't have to load ourselves with heavy requirements, good deeds, pure thoughts, blameless hearts, perfect obedience, in order to be able to scratch our way to happiness in this life and salvation in the next. Jesus is with us in that journey. Trust in divine providence is expressed so well in the Serenity Prayer. Dear God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. It was this trust in divine providence that got me through the months of the fourth quarter. To accept the reality of the shutdown, which I had no control over, and to try to do the best I could to help you navigate it. When the faculty and staff gathered at school on March 16th and 17th to to transition to distance teaching, it felt like we were at a funeral wake. It wasn't so much our fear of the pandemic as it was an absence of the girls. The girls would be not there for the rest of the school year. And I think we also were mourning along with you the loss of a normal fourth quarter of your senior year, which all the fun things that would have been a part of that final quarter. And so people who are grounded in divine providence and have the serenity and courage to lead beatitude lives influence the world for good. They can no more escape notice than a city on a hill. And so, seniors, in the words of today's gospel, as you go forth, let this light shine before others in the next chapters of your life. And take with you God's words through the prophet Jeremiah, "For I know well the plans I have in mind for you, says the Lord, plans for your welfare and not for woe, so as to give you a future full of hope." In Jesus' name, amen. And now we proceed to the commissioning and blessing of the graduates. So if you could all stand, please. Your DSHA education has taught you to be women with an awareness of a loving God who promote the gospel message of Christ Jesus. So I ask you to respond to each of the following questions. I will. Will you follow in the footsteps of Jesus as a modern-day disciple in a world that needs your spirit? Will you continually pursue relationships with family, friends, community, with a sense of integrity and purpose? Will you help to lead future generations into the warmth and promise of God's light? Will you be of service to others, actively entering into the struggle for a more just society? Dashers, before you were even formed, God knew you. While you were in your mother's womb, God named you. At your birth, God's breath filled you with life. Today, we celebrate what you have become at this moment in time. Please bow your heads for a special blessing. God of our beginnings, we thank you for the gifts of these graduates, their excitement, their awesome wonder and curiosity, their open speech and encouraging words. Their contributions have blessed and challenged us, and we have become richer and the more diverse community because of them. As they step forward into the world that awaits, comfort their fears with the full knowledge of your divine presence. Strengthen their resolve to walk in the footsteps of Jesus as modern-day disciples in a world that needs their spirit. Guide their feet as they move through life, protecting them from the pitfalls of darkness while they help to lead future generations into the warmth and promise of your life. We ask this blessing upon each of them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Godspeed.
You can have a seat. It's now my honor to introduce Sister Grace Mary Croft, SDS, Sponsorship Coordinator for the Sisters of the Divine Savior. Sister Grace Mary was not able to be with us today, so her greeting and prayer has been pre-recorded.
On behalf of the Sisters of the Divine Savior, who proudly sponsor DSHA, it is an honor for me to greet all of you, graduates of the class of 2020, parents, family, administration, faculty, counselors, and friends on this special event. This is a historical time of our life, as we are in the midst of a pandemic, which is pointing to our fragility and to the systemic inequalities in our society, as well as to the heroic possibilities deep within each of us. This is also a historical year for the Sisters of the Divine Savior, for Divine Savior High School, and for Divine Savior Holy Angels High School. 125 years ago, on July 4th, our first Sisters of the Divine Savior arrived in Milwaukee close to midnight to the sounds and sights of fireworks. On May 3rd and September 14th, 1950, 70 years ago, ground was broken and the cornerstone was laid for Divine Savior High School, the center of the building today. And 50 years ago, in 1970, plans were laid and the school year began with the merged schools of Divine Savior and Holy Angels, DSHA as we know and love it today. Dear graduates, I hope and pray that you leave DSHA confident that your education has provided you with a solid foundation for your future vocations and careers, and that your good memories and friends will remain with you in years to come. We sisters wish you many blessings on your life's journey with our Divine Savior, who is the way, and with the Holy Angels as your protectors. And so let us pray. Divine Savior Jesus Christ, we thank you for taking on human nature and becoming one of us. We thank you, especially today, for this opportunity amidst the coronavirus pandemic to celebrate the graduation of the Divine Savior Holy Angels class of 2020. These young women have been challenged by the uncertainty of this time, as well as by the adjustments to new ways of learning and relating to others. We know, Lord, that it is through your goodness and love that these young women are here today to celebrate their graduation. We thank you for your grace and for their families, teachers, and friends who encourage them along the way and are celebrating with them today. Divine Savior, grant these graduates your spirit so that they may serve you with joy wherever and to whatever you call them. Bless and guide them on their journey of life so that through them, others will come to know you, the Savior of the world. We ask this through the intercession of Mary, your mother, all the holy angels, and all holy apostles. Amen.
Before we move to the presentation of the class of 2020, it is my privilege and honor to introduce to you our next speakers. Each year, the valedictorian is the student with the highest grade point average after seven semesters. This year, we have two valedictorians. Please congratulate and welcome Anna Klempe and Lucia Pekloff as the valedictorians.
So that was kind of a long walk. Hi, my name is Anna Klempe, and I am one of the valedictorians of the DSHA class of 2020. It's crazy to think that 4 years have come and gone already. 4 years of dash-a-thons, state championships, pep rallies, musicals, and spirit weeks. DSHA has been and always will be my second home, and it's surreal to think that right here and right now, we start a new chapter in our lives, leaving those familiar hallways and classrooms in the pages prior. There are a lot of things I want to say to my class as we part ways, including dozens of ways to say thank you, thousands of ways to say I love you, and countless stories. But I'll save the sad stuff for later. This isn't a goodbye as much as it's a see you later. So I want to use my time here to describe just how proud I am of this class, especially considering where we've all been these past few months. Our class is special in a lot of ways, and although it took weeks of reflecting for me to be able to define what truly makes our class more special than the rest, I ended up coming up with one single word that distinguishes us: resilience. As I was thinking back on my memories from high school, my mind went immediately to all the good things I mentioned earlier. Dash-a-thon, homecoming, all-school masses, air band, Christmas in the quad, winning Empress Crown every year, and lots of plaid. But as I thought harder, I realized how much our class had to go through in order to get here. We experienced heartbreak, loss, intense highs and intense lows, failure. In our senior year alone, we experienced a global pandemic, several eye-opening tragedies that inspired the greatest political tension we've ever known, and weeks of solitude when we needed our sisters the most. I thought back to some days that we didn't think we'd survive, days when it felt like the world was against us, days that pushed us beyond what we thought our limits were, days that tested our faith. I think back to those days and I can't help but wonder, how did we survive them? And I came to the conclusion that we, as young women of faith, are far stronger than we could ever know. Because despite it all, we came to school or hopped on Microsoft Teams every day and strive for excellence. We still took up leadership positions every chance we could, tried out for the teams we'd always dreamed of making, and joked around with our friends in the hallways. On a daily basis, we demonstrated an inner drive, strength, and resilience that we didn't even realize we had until we looked back on our hardest days and wondered how we survived them. Until we looked back and saw all the ways our class pushed through tragedy only to come out on the other side with smiles on our faces, messy buns in our hair, and determination in our eyes. As we've seen throughout history, society will often use femininity to connote weakness or frailty, but look at these past 4 years. We made it through every day we didn't think we could survive, and not only that, but we did it with the grace and elegance that only a Dasher could have. Today, we experience all of the joy and pride that we have rightfully earned, but we also step out into a world that will have its fair share of hard days waiting for us around the corner. We are about to step into a world where we may be pushed down, where we may hear more no's than yeses, where we may feel too tired to keep going. I wish there was something I could say or do to put a positive spin on the coming days, but given the truly incredible sequence of events that has taken place this year, I'm just as terrified and confused and worried as you are. At this point, we truly won't know what's in store for us until we're standing right in front of it. But I do know one thing. No matter what happens, at our cores, we will always be Dashers. If there's anything our high school experience, and especially our senior year, has proven, it's that our faith is stronger than our fear, and we can overcome any struggle if we place our trust in God. At our cores, we are resilient and powerful and important. At our cores, we are leaders, believers, critical thinkers, communicators, and self-advocates. At our cores, we are brave, even beyond the halls of DSHA. So no matter what may be in store, ladies, continue to seek excellence in all that you do. Take up leadership positions every chance you can. Go for the job you've always dreamed of having. Use your hardest days to fuel your determination, and use that determination to change the world for the better. You are made of the best things the world has to offer. And please know that while scary days might be waiting around the corner, your best days are waiting just beyond that, and I know you're strong enough to get there. It certainly helps that we've had and will continue to have incredible cheerleaders along the way. To all the parents and siblings and grandparents out there who helped us get where we are, thank you for your endless support. To every teacher, staff member, and counselor who helped us get here, thank you for pushing us to be better women each and every day, for challenging us to go outside our comfort zones, and above all, for modeling the virtues we should all strive to achieve. And finally, to all of my Dasher sisters sitting before me, thank you for being the best family I ever could have asked for. I can't wait to see all the ways you change the world, and know that if you ever need anything, we will always be here for you. Just remember going forth that God has a plan. Trust that everything will happen exactly like it's supposed to, and please know that you are far stronger than you think you are. This class was built to make a difference, to enact change, and to be forces of creativity, justice, and strength in the world. We are confident, we are capable, we are resilient. It's time to go out and show them what we've got. Thank you.
To my beautiful class of 2020. Our journey here began 4 years ago as we opened to a new chapter in our young lives, to a new adventure, to a place which has become our second home, Divine Savior, Holy Angels. Here, everyone wears a smile, and yes, even a glad to be plaid skirt. The students are full of enthusiasm as they walk down the hallways, and the energy is contagious. Laughter echoes throughout the building as friendships are nurtured, dreams are encouraged, and tomorrows are impatiently anticipated. Looking back at my first day of freshman year, I longed to be a part of this sisterhood. I wanted to find a circle of friends who would accept me for who I am. I admired the determination of each student and hope that I, too, could eventually grow in confidence. In time, I formed friendships and began to pursue opportunities that were once unimaginable. Through joining clubs and volunteering with various organizations, I began to realize that we all have the power to make a difference. Our diverse student body has allowed us to learn and embrace many viewpoints and perspectives. Our established faculty and staff encouraged us to question, investigate, and use our talents to serve others. The rigorous curriculum challenged us academically and motivated us to explore our dreams and passions. Our classes and retreats deepened our faith and gave us a better understanding of God, of what is truly important in life, and of the impact we can make in the lives of one another every day. One smile at a time, one kind word at a time, one person at a time. I have worked very hard these past 4 years. We all have. We've been taught to take material, digest it, reflect upon it, and use it as a springboard for further learning and inquiry. Slowly and lovingly, Divine Savior, Holy Angels has transformed us into self-assured young women who can accomplish the impossible and start again, even when disappointment confronts us. For our class, disappointment came sooner than we could have ever imagined. I guess the world had a different plan for us, a plan that would abruptly change our lives. From one day to the next, we lost the ability to come to school, sit in our classes, and see each other every day. Social distancing has become our new normal and has defined our last few months of high school. During these many long days at home, I often found myself reminiscing about the little things I'd once taken for granted here. I miss sitting with my friends at lunch and listening to each other's stories. I miss belting out to songs during our car rides to school and studying in the library each morning. I miss gathering in the commons and planning what we were going to wear to the next dance. I even miss that fluttery feeling in my stomach right before taking a test and the late nights perfecting that paper or assignment. I miss the familiar faces, the smiles, the hugs, and the laughter. I miss all of you, my sisters. Despite these obstacles, our senior class has remained strong and united. We have found new ways to stay positive, connect, celebrate, and stand as one. If there is any lesson that we must take with us as we leave our beloved school, it is to treasure the now, the present, today. We should never take for granted anything we have, any person we love, or any opportunity we are given. And as we move into the world, we must be quick to act, open to reflect, and brave enough to lead. Our country is currently living in turmoil. We are witnessing the real consequences of racial injustice and social inequality. These are not just themes, ideas, or subjects studied in our books. There are real people with names, faces, and families who will forever be seared into our memories. There is division, there is anger, there is fear. We must begin to listen to one another and stand together more than ever before. We must continue to educate ourselves and learn to have difficult conversations. We must treat one another with the dignity and kindness each of us deserves, regardless of race, ethnicity, gender, and sexuality. We must use our voices to create good and strive to achieve equality. Together, we can change the world. We can make a world in which there is more compassion and respect. We can do this. We must do this. We, the class of 2020, are confident young women who are capable of accomplishing anything we set our minds to. We are the leaders of tomorrow. Let us follow the good examples taught to us here and move forward with courage. Let us trust in God, believe in ourselves, and never lose sight of hope. As we approach the new journey that lies ahead, let us soar with a graceful strength, embrace all that life...
and recognize the salutatorian for the class of 2020. I'd invite you to stand and be recognized. Congratulations, Anna Wozniak. You'll get to hear from Anna at the end. It's now time to present the class of 2020 to receive their diploma covers. You received your diplomas at home in the mail. In fact, there should have been a nice note from a member of the faculty and staff included with that. In order to assure that names are heard, I'd ask that we refrain from applause and cheering until all of the graduates have walked across the stage. And because we did not have a chance to practice, I've got a few logistical notes for you. Mrs. Brock and Mrs. Rodriguez-Reed will dismiss you from your chairs. And we're gonna ask that we maintain physical distancing through this process. You may leave your masks on the chairs and your flowers when you're dismissed from your seat. Ms. Colin Ritter will be over here at the stairs, kind of queuing you up the stairs. You can use the fence posts as a guide. They're approximately 6 feet apart. When your name is called, you will walk across the stage in front. Mrs. Konechny will put the diploma cover on the table. They are demonstrating. Dr. Mansfield, nice job. At the tall table, grab your diploma cover, and then there will not be a handshake today. You will stop at the X, and Mrs. Konechny is standing on that X. Hold your diploma kind of at chest height. Smile. Remember, you won't have your mask on at that point, so smile. Ms. Kristen here is the photographer, and she will take your picture, so look directly at her. Then you'll exit opposite stage and return to your seat and put your face mask back on, okay? All right. With that, Mrs. Brock and Mrs. Rodriguez-Reed are going to get us started here. Okay, we're going to get started. Tazania Anderson. Ella Paige Anich. Nayeli Arenas Garcia. Carolyn Kelly Ash. Mia Catherine Bando. Sydney Catherine Bannock. Georgia Barzak. Lena Udell Bukite. Paige Marie Bierke. Hannah Lynn Bruckman. Grace Elizabeth Brunner. Nora Marie Byrne. Daniela Crystal Camarillo. Lillian Lorraine Cantwell. Morgan Suzanne Cassetta. Natalia Cavazos. Anna Catherine Cesars. Kismat Chahal. Sarah Barnes Christensen. Monica Rose Coffey. Greta Coca. Julia Ava Cologne. Kennedy Ray Conklin. Daniela Corona Chavez. Colleen Francis Zarnecki. Desiree Jacqueline Dankovich. Lyra Margaret Davis. Ariana De La Torre Sanchez. Eileen Claudia DeGeer. Molly Dugan. Gracie Marie Dunn. Claudia Mercedes Eisenreich. Jessica Krisovna Emanuel. Karen Itzel Escoda Castro. Alejandra Espino. Ilya Denise Estrada Anaya. Annika Elizabeth Bitterer. Abigail Elizabeth Fleischman. Caroline Elizabeth Fleick. Ellen Moran Fricker. Aaliyah Garcia. Cassandra Garcia Campos. Cecilia Teresa Garcia Velez. Amy Shirley Geringer. Jacqueline Lorraine Geringer. Leah Christine Giese. Aaliyah Catherine Glinsky. Moira Ann Gonzalez. Annabelle Drew Griffith Tops. Grace Catherine Grogan. Magdalena Natalia Guerrero. Natalie Elizabeth Hall. Pilar Hernandez. Maritza Citlali Hernandez Sanchez. Sophia Clara Hernandez. Leslie Nayeli Hernandez Ruiz. Maura Caitlin Hodan. Riley Paige Honkamp. Teresa Ann Ruse. May Ellen Hurtado Thiele. Isabella Therese Hushett. Keely Shea Hyland. Rose Cecilia Ingrassano. Mikkel Irfan. Jacqueline O'Hagan Jarris. Fatima Natalia Jimenez Gonzalez. Annika Johnson. Mary Margaret Kaup. Abigail Elizabeth Kaiser. Soraya Martha Kaiser. Meredith Elaine Kent. Emma Elizabeth Kirshner. Cameron Elizabeth Keys. Anna Lynn Klempe. Elizabeth Ann Klingsborn. Jacqueline Marie Comas. Grace Margaret Kozna. Faith Ann Crana. Claire Diane Keene. Tierney Ulina Kulyu. Annalise Marie Lamperer. Lauren Elizabeth Lancaster. Jana Rose Leroux. Ella Rose Larscheid. Olivia Ellen Larson. Helen Elise Lillick. Madalena Victoria Luna. Isabel Ann Lutz. Brooke Catherine Mackey. Elsa Mildred Major. Emma Taylor Mangarelli. Megan Moran Mansfield. Dolores Ann Martinez. Emily Joyce Maslowski. Mary Teresa McDonald. Danny Gabriella Melendez. Murphy Coughlin Mellows. Mikieski. Anna Catherine Miski. Catherine Mary Morton. Lucy Rose Miller. Margaret Ann Mullen. Lillian Grace Nation. Laura Eleanor Nizgoda. Alexandra Marie Nan. Megan Rose Novotny. Jaden Marie O'Brien. Caitlin Lauren O'Hare. Aaron Wally O'Neill. Mary Rose Otten. Maya Belinish Otto. Elizabeth Ann Parks. Amira Ruby Pearsall. Lucia Gina Irme Pekloff. Paola Pena. Kiera Nicole Pruitt. Yeah. Haley Lynn Quinnett. Lucy Elizabeth Radica. Alejandra Razo Velasquez. Maura Jane Reardon. Maura Tian Reardon. Catherine Lauren Riley. Jasmine Brianna Reyes. Allison Lee Richburg. Jalen Rivas Rodriguez. Kylie Tiana Robbins. Rachel Elizabeth Roberts. Ileana Veronica Rojo. Mackenzie Therese Rose. Jocelyn Guadalupe Sanchez Cortez. Alexandra Vienne Sandoval. Jordan Patricia Schifano. Hannah Morgan Schladweiler. Elizabeth Margaret Schlegel. Rosemary Claire Schlitt. Marianne Elizabeth Schneider. Lauren Ann Schraffnagel. Samantha Elizabeth Schreck. Madeline Elise Schultz. Holly Anna Schwanebeck. Caitlin Elizabeth Schwartz. Jaylee Marie Szymanski. Caroline Rose Simon. Elizabeth Ann Ton Sklenars. Ella Janae Sobchak. Sonia Jolies. Natalie Ann Stamper. Mary Elizabeth Stern. Clarissa Jean Strother. Elizabeth Kim Talmadge. Willow Quinn Typel. Alexa Venkata Samala Thoda. Emma May Urban. Jillian Georgia Ventrek. Claire Margaret Vapp. Claire Elizabeth Watson. Elena Ciara Wilson. Anna Michelle Wozniak. Tajari Mahat Celeste Wright. Elizabeth Claire Robluski. Teresa Claire Yacek. Mama Usankuma Kukabra York. Kiernan Marie Zalewski. Jenna Nina Dentisi Zalkowski. Eve Irene Zukowski. On behalf of the entire faculty and staff at DSHA, please join me in congratulating the class of 2020. The next aspect of our program is recognition for our medalists and a special welcome to the class of 2020 as alumni of DSHA. In addition, your names will be etched forever in the history wall of the R.J. Friedel Commons. And to recognize the medalists and to welcome the entire class of 2020 to the honorable alumni group is President Katie Konechny, DSHA 1992.
Congratulations. It is wonderful to see each of you here today, and we were just so grateful to be able to see you in person. So truly, from the bottom of my heart and from everyone who worked so hard to put this together, congratulations to you all. As people of faith, we know and believe that all that we experience is a gift from God. The gifts in this school community are abundant, and at this time of year, we are so keenly aware of that. I can feel the love amongst each and every one of you and the families and the graduates that are here today, and the true appreciation that each of you have been able to gather together today in person, celebrate your 4 years here at DSHA, and pray together one last time as a class. Now I'd like to take a moment to recognize our senior medalists and their families. Our medalist families are some of the human relationships that have been central to the lives of our graduates and to the vitality of our school. We celebrate our 128 years as an all-girls Catholic high school, with our origins dating back to the founding of Holy Angels Academy in 1892. Of the rich legacy and the many special traditions that we have at DSHA, celebrating our medalists each year is one of my favorites. What is a medalist, and why is that so very special to DSHA? A medalist is a graduate who is following in the footsteps of a family member that has graduated from either Divine Savior, Holy Angels Academy, or Divine Savior, Holy Angels. Our school has been recognizing graduate medalists since 1925. In the fall of 1921, a young woman named Eleanor Carroll, daughter of Catherine McGuire Carroll, Holy Angels class of 1897, enrolled the first daughter of an alumna. With her graduation 4 years later, and every year since, we have recognized and honored this privilege of being able to educate multiple generations of women from the same family through the medalist tradition. To continue to earn that confidence in the ongoing relationships with the families is something of which we are extremely proud. In this moment, we shine a light on the fact that we have been around for a really long time, and the formation of young women of faith, heart, and intellect has been valued in this community for 128 years. We are still standing on the shoulders of the many people who went before us, and I cherish the moments that we visibly demonstrate that we remember, and more importantly, that we value our legacy. I want to extend my gratitude to the alumni director who's here today, Danielle Jaromski-Robb, DSHA class of 2008, for the planning and preparation that she has done to celebrate you. Yesterday, she, along with a team of faculty and staff, delivered your medals and your roses to each family. So at this time, I'd like to ask all of our medalists and family members who are here today to please stand to be recognized. Thank you so very much for your dedication to DSHA. All right. And I get to do the next piece, which is to officially welcome the class of 2020 into our alumna. In addition, as Mr. Quinnell said, your names are going to be etched forever in the walls in the Friedel Commons. And as a fellow Dasher myself, class of 1992, I'm honored to be the first ones to welcome you. You are part of this 128 years of history, and we are proud of each and every one of you. You've been part of joining the alumni of DSHA is expanding your sisterhood beyond the class of 2020 to a larger community of women that go beyond the walls of DSHA. At this time, I ask all of the alumni of Holy Angels Academy, Divine Savior High School, and Divine Savior Holy Angels High School who are present with us today to please stand. We represent a group of over 14,000 women who have been educated through a common mission, and as a result, possess a passion to push ourselves and achieve what God has made possible through our faith, heart, and intellect. Graduates, please stand and look around you. You are now part of something much bigger than your class of 2020. The faith, tradition, vision, and successes of the alumni have been passed on to you, and they have been woven into the fabric of our school, just as each of you have been. Their stories are now yours, and it is our hope that you will learn from them and add to them. Alumni, please extend your hand toward the graduates. As alumni, we pray for each of you in the class of 2020. We keep you in our prayers as each of you begins your new journey. We welcome you to the Alumni Association, and we hold you to the high standards passed down since 1892. Congratulations to our newest members of the Divine Savior Holy Angels alumni.
You guys can have a seat again. Each year, the senior class votes to select the next speaker. The class is invited to identify the characteristics they feel embody the spirit of the class. Members of the class are then nominated for this honor, and the class votes amongst the nominees. This next speaker represents the spirit of the graduating class. Please welcome Jackie Geringer.
Okay. Wow. This was an unexpected turn of events, wasn't it? I'm sure none of us could have guessed high school would end this way, but here we are. And let's be real, if this was going to happen to any class, it makes sense that it happened to ours. Right now, we're living in a time of uncertainty, confusion, and change. But then again, if there's any class that can power through this and come out stronger, it's also ours. I mean, four of us, myself included, were born on 9/11, so I guess shout out to Keely, Amy, and Paige. We all look towards the future with a bittersweet feeling, but I'd like to focus a little bit on the past. The year was 2016, and Absolute Bangers, like Stressed Out by 21 Pilots, and Closer by the Chainsmokers played through our earbuds. Not AirPods, not yet. We danced to My Boo and drank our water with our sticker-covered Nalgene water bottles. And in our free time, we played Pokemon Go. We did, however, experience the loss of Vine, but we had the Kimmy and Tajari show to make up for that. Times were simpler. As sophomore year rolled around, we changed our Birkenstocks out for Chacos, but for some reason, we kept the socks. When we were bored, we played with fidget spinners and slime. We pretended the floor was lava and debated whether we heard Yanny or Laurel. Sophomore year also introduced us to one of the biggest struggles we were ever faced with, not being able to have our phones in class. Then junior year came along, and we changed our small plaid out for the big plaid. We had our horses in the back, and honestly, we should have kept them there. Our rugby team killed it and won state, but the senior class that year didn't do so hot with their senior prank. Although we weren't able to pull our own off, I'm pretty sure the cops wouldn't have been called. And who could forget the multiple fire alarms for burnt popcorn in the microwave? And then came senior year. Well, firstly, senior year was the debut of these bad boys. I want to give our class a quick shout out for not giving in to the Visco girl trend, unlike a certain junior class this year. Instead, we dressed up as E-boys for Halloween. We beat the teachers in the seniors versus teachers basketball game by a landslide, and we're awesome Spirit Patrol leaders for Dashathon. We were introduced to the wonderful mind of Father Patrick and went on the spiritual and immersive journey of Vocare and never came back. Over the years, if there's one thing we've experienced, it was change. Whether it was saying goodbye to loved faculty members and saying hello to new ones, or dealing with the inconsistent and confusing schedules, or, hell, a pandemic, we've adapted. It's what we do, and in some ways, it's all we can do. The next few years of our lives will undoubtedly entail change. New faces, new settings, new routines. And although the unexpected can be scary, it can also be freeing. So I encourage everyone, myself included, to be open to the change we will face and embrace it. Allow yourself to grow, accept new opinions, and welcome new experiences. As many of you know, I've had my fair share of struggles, and I know many of you have as well, but those challenges have only made us stronger and prepared us for what lies ahead. And if this pandemic has taught us anything, it's that we make the most of our change and we thrive. Our class voted on what characteristics we think best describe us. I was surprised and honestly a little insulted no one said insanely intelligent or drop-dead gorgeous, but it's fine, I'll get over it. All jokes aside, I think the top three traits we voted for perfectly describe us. The third most voted for characteristic was funny, which is a given considering we have Jonna and Morgan in our class. We were always able to look at the brighter side of things and make the most of the situation with a joke or two. The second most popular characteristic was strong, and I really don't have anything else to add to that. Yes, we were strong over the years, even for freshmen, but our strength really shined during our last semester. We powered through it all. Lastly, our most voted for characteristic, and the one that makes me the proudest, was inclusive. I remember seeing peers of different social groups hanging out and laughing, and overwhelmingly happy to see each other get along. We have some amazing women in our class. We got Jaden, who's gonna get gold in the Olympics someday. We got Moira, who will probably get canonized just for existing. We got Elsa, who will invent some insanely complicated machine. And we got Megan, who will be our president someday. Novotny, not Mansfield. The bottom line is, we have some insanely inspiring and talented women in our class, and it's such an honor to be able to call you guys my sisters. I mean, I've been calling Amy that for a while, but that's besides the point. We have a spirit that is simply unmatched by any other. Can you name a class that has gotten not just a repeat, not just a three-peat, but a four-peat? The answer is no, you can't, because no one's ever done that before. When we come together, we kind of kill it. We came together for the good times, like partying like Gatsby for the black tie Christmas, but we also came together in times of loss and sadness. And whether we realize it or not, over the past 4 years, we grew as a family. And the thing about family is, no matter how much they get on your nerves sometimes, Amy, we always have each other's back. And I know it's a huge cliche to call you guys family, but get over it. Just a quick little anecdote. I remember 1 week in last year, first semester, I was really down, like very visibly down. Then one day I looked in my mailbox and saw a note that said, "Angels are watching over you. Their wings wrap gently around you, whispering you are loved and blessed." It touched me so much that I hung it on my bedroom wall. Whoever left that in my mailbox didn't write their name, so I will never know who was looking out for me, but I will never forget that moment. During one of my darkest times, one of my peers was there for me, rooting for me. It showed me how lucky I am to be a part of my class and how welcomed and cared for I am. Lastly, I would like to say thank you. Thank you to our parents and grandparents that drove us to our games and watched our performances. Thank you to our brothers and sisters that picked us up and dropped us off at school. Thank you to our generous alumni and donors. And most importantly, thank you to our faculty and staff. Over the past 4 years, you have helped us grow and become the amazing young women we are today. You have taught us many lessons in both academics and in life, and have shown us care and compassion. And although I greatly appreciate the love and kindness I received over the past 4 years, I will never forget the support and understanding I got during quarantine. Thank you for caring for us and seeing us as more than students, but as people. For wanting the best for us, for putting aside grades and due dates and focusing on our well-being. During a time so stressful and confusing, you were there to provide comfort and support. We are all so blessed to have you in our lives, and I know I'm not the only one who feels this way. Finally, I would like to thank the class of 2020. Thank you for the memories I will cherish. Thank you for the small talk in the hallways, the hellos in the lunch line, and the stupid little inside jokes I'll remember randomly someday in the future. Thank you for nominating me to be your class speaker. I hope I did an okay job. And I think the Pennies have one more question.
Jackie, it's been well established that this is a strong class, and they made a strong choice in choosing you. Job well done. I'd like to take this moment to thank a few folks. Pulling together a graduation in a pandemic was a challenge. I'm especially grateful to Ruby Brock, class of 92, Stephanie Chosnick, Dawn Hathaway, Amanda Marsala, Maria Naki, and so many others who worked to make this day possible here at the Washington County Fairgrounds. As we are in a pandemic, we plan the event today considering all of the health and safety mitigation plans we could implement to assure for the safety and well-being of all participants today. And we thank you for your cooperation. These plans include the procession out following the ceremony. Each member of the class of 2020 will be released in a manner that allows for social distancing to remain in place until you are safely back at your car. Parents, you've been arranged in the same alpha order as your daughter. Once each graduate reaches her parents, we ask that you continue the dismissal procession to your cars. Class of 2020, please remain in your seat until you're dismissed by Mrs. Brock and Mrs. Rodriguez-Reed. And now to conclude our ceremony, I'd like to invite salutatorian Anna Wozniak to the stage to lead us in the class prayer that you will find in the back of your commencement book. Class of 2020, please stand and face your parents.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Heavenly Father, as we graduate from DSHA, we take time to reflect on our past 4 years. We recognize all of the ways that you have been present, Lord, and are grateful for the way in which your love binds us all. Our journey at DSHA would not be complete without our wonderful teachers, parents, guardians, coaches, counselors, and everyone who has helped us along the way. We want to especially thank them for their patience and understanding during our transition to online learning. Thank you, Lord, for bringing these special people into our lives. We thank you, Lord, for the group of women we have laughed with, cried with, grown with, and gotten to know over these past 4 years of high school. As Dashers, we graduate together and each have our own unique story, but together we make up a class of inspiring, loyal, and compassionate women. We have exhibited passion for our school, unlike any other class, and despite our differences, we get along and work together. This solidarity as a class has made all our entire high school experience one to remember. Looking back on the past 4 years, we recognize the highs and lows we have experienced on stage, on the court, in class, on the field, in clubs, and at home. Despite loss and sadness, we have been constantly surrounded by the love and support of our sisters. The connections we have made will forever lift us up as we recall the memories we made with our sisters. We are eternally grateful for your everlasting presence in our lives, in both good and bad times. As we all step into this pivotal chapter of our lives, embarking on the next step of our journey in different places all around the country, may we remember that we can always find a home in you, Lord, and at Divine Savior Holy Angels. Guide us through any tough situations we encounter during this transition, and help us to remember that through change comes growth. We ask that you remind us every day that love truly does bind all. Whether we are 1,000 miles away from our best friend, missing playing the sport we love, or wishing we were back in high school, help us to understand that our class is closer than most due to the unique circumstances we have encountered.